is going on, Pokemon fans? Welcome back to JD's Nerdverse. We are doing a playthrough today of Pokemon Crystal with Kangaskhan, the parent Pokemon. It is Mother's Day weekend, and I decided to do something a little out of pocket. So usually we play through with the Pokédex order, so I can't skip over Pokemon I don't want to play through as. It forces me to do it. But we're going to play through as Kangaskhan because it is Mother's Day weekend. All Kangaskhans are moms. And our rival, we chose Chikorita, not the biggest deal in the world. Any rival Pokemon that comes up, we're going to have, like, any starter we'd have given our rival would have been obliterated. So, but anyway, let's go ahead and go over the stats of this Pokemon. Because Kangaskhan starts off with 105 HP. Attack is 95, defense is 80, special attack is 40, special defense is 80, and speed is 90. So every stat with this Pokemon is solid, if not good, except for special attack. Which is a shame because this is a Pokemon that has pretty good move diversity. So we do have some special moves that we can use to help us get through the game, especially some certain parts of the game. However, we don't have great special attack. We will mitigate that as much as we can with some vitamins. But in essence, we do not have, that is our worst stat. Our best stat is our HP, followed shortly by attack and speed, and then defense, special defense is 80. So attack, very good physical attack. All normal moves are physical, so that's going to work great. We also get really good access to some other moves in the game, so that's going to work great as well. So we're finishing up with this route here, and what we're doing is just playing through all these Pokemon here. Getting some levels. We do have a decent level up move pool, which you're going to see here in a little bit. And I should have really just cut this part out, but I thought I'd just throw it in just so you know what we do up until we get the Bellsprout Tower. So like I said, Mother's Day weekend, where this is the mother Pokemon, the parent Pokemon. So it's going to be great. I don't know what Pokemon to do for Father's Day. Let me know what you think I should do for Father's Day in the comment section down below. That's coming up in June. So that being said, we're going to go and beat this trainer, and we're going to move on to Bellsprout Tower. We're going to go over our move set. So we start off with Comet Punch at level 1, 18 base power. It's 20, roughly, 27 with stab, 85% accurate. I hate the accuracy on this move, and that's part of the problem why it takes so long early to get through all this stuff. We got to go back and heal. We get Leer, which will lower the opposite defense. We start using that just to do more damage with Comet Punch. Bite is a great move to have because it's 60 base power, 100% accurate. I think we need this to beat Faulkner just to make it a clear, concise win. It can't make the opposition flinch, but it's great because this move can attack ghosts, and we are normal type, so most normal types don't get any moves like that. Tail Whip lowers the defense just like Leer. Mega Punch, 80 base power, 85% accurate. It's 120 with stab, but the accuracy with this isn't good enough. I'd rather just go with a more reliable move. Rage, if we got it early, it'd be great, but as late as we get it, not useful. 30 base power with stab, 100% accurate. Endure, don't know what it does. Dizzy Punch, pretty much the same as Headbutt, and I think Headbutt's just, you get earlier and there's no point in kind of leading it. Headbutt, if you go first, which this Pokemon has good speed, but Headbutt, if you go first, it makes the opposition flinch, and in reversal, not quite sure what it does, but I'm not going to worry about it. There's other moves I'm going to use rather than reversal. So that's our level up move set. Could we beat the game with this? Absolutely. Comet Punch, solid starting move, I guess. Bite, counters Ghosts. But we're going to go ahead and go over the TM move set, and as you can see, it's moving. As usual, Dynamic Punch is not useful. It's 100 base power, 50% accurate. I guess it would be great maybe for like a fighting Pokemon in a pinch be used, but we're not going to. Headbutt, very useful. 70 base power, 105 with stab, 100% accurate, makes the opposition flinch. Works very well with this Pokemon, good attack stat with good physical moves, and it's a normal move with stab, and there's other things that add to that. Curse, Roar, Toxic. Not going to use Zap Cannon. Would be great if it wasn't horrible accuracy. We do not use Rock Smash. We will use Hidden Power. We're going to go with Hidden Power Flying. The biggest weakness for normal types in Generation 2 is Fighting type, and we have a Gym Leader and an Elite Four member that'll help against. So Hidden Power Flying is the way to go. 70 base power. Sunny Day and Storm Rock. Blizzard will be used later. 120 base power. Horrible actually, but it's worth it. It's very powerful. Hyper Beam, not going to use. Icy Wind, Protect, Rain Dance, Endure, Frustration, not going to use. Iron Tail can be used, but we're not going to use it. Thunder, powerful, but not going to use. I hate the accuracy on this. Earthquake, very useful. 100 base power, 100% accurate, hits ghosts. So it replace, at one point it will replace Bite. And it will also just be a very good move with our physical attack. Return, 102 base power when maxed out. It's 152 whenever it's going a little too fast. Shadow Ball won't use, Mud Slap won't use, we will use it for a little bit. Double Team, Ice Punch will be very useful against Dragon types. Swagger, Sleep Talk, Sandstorm. Rest of the moves pretty much won't be used other than Thunder Punch and Fire Punch. But I want to go back to Return. So Return is 152 base power. And with that, you can get the Pink Bow, which adds 10% boost to normal moves. You can also add a Pink Bow, and Whitney will give us a 10% boost to normal attacks as well. So that becomes one of our best moves. It really does. So that's our move set, and it went. I thought it was going to go a little too slow for my talk over, but it actually went a little fast, but it's okay. All the moves are listed in the comments section down below. You can go to the link and go to Kangaskhan Generation 2, and I'll go over all that stuff with you. So now we're going to face Faulkner. Faulkner is the flying type trainer, and he comes out with a Pidgey. Pidgey is going to be, I missed two times in a row right there, so there's actually a Comet Punch at its best. Three times it missed. So we do get a three-hit Comet Punch, which is knocks out in one turn. Critical hit with Pidgeotto. It's going to take one more hit. Done. Very easy win over Faulkner. Like I said, level 13 was just a precautionary tale. So what we're going to do now is going to backtrack, and we're going to talk to this lady here. Her name is Tuscany of Tuesday, and she's going to give us the Pink Bow. So what the Pink Bow does, it gives us 10% boost in all normal moves. So Comet Punch right now, 10% boosted. If we get Headbutt, 10% boosted, so on and so forth. So, Bite will be a 3-shot on the Metapod. We're facing Bugsy now. He is the Bug Trainer. We skipped over the Slowpoke Well. We usually show that, but this stuff's pretty trivial. With Slowpoke Well, we just obliterated everything. And now we're coming up against Scyther. Scyther will be a 2-shot. It's like multiple shots, but it's 2 turns of attack. Okay, we don't learn Tail Whip. Tail Whip's the same as Leer. We don't need it. So after we beat Bugsy, we're going to go ahead and we're going to face our rival. Now, our rival usually is a big pain in the butt in this playthrough because it always has like a ghastly, which causes problems. However, we have a move called Bite, which is Dark type. Dark type super effective against Ghost type. So this ghastly will be like a non-issue. So let's go ahead and use Bite. 1-shot, very good. And now we have 2 Pokemon left. Zubat, which Bite will be a 3-shot. Well, we do get the flinch, so that's good. And then the last move, Bayleaf. Bayleaf will be multiple shots because Bite doesn't do nothing at all. So Comet Punch gets a 2-hit there, and we just need one more Comet Punch to hit. If we miss, that could be bad, but, Razor Leaf, okay, good. We got the knockout. That was scary, but we beat our rival, and we're going to move on to Ekrotik Forest. Ekrotik Forest is not much in here, but there's a very, very nice TM we can get called Headbutt. Headbutt is a 70 base power, 105 base, or 105 with Stab, let me rephrase that. And it's a very powerful move we can add and immediately upgrades our moveset. Because Comet Punch is our best normal move that we have Stab and whatever add-on. So we get that and progress. To Whitney's Gym. And Whitney's Gym is going to be a cakewalk. We are normal type, so we shouldn't have any advantage over us. But we just have great moves. We went and did a whole bunch of errands. Fought a couple extra trainers in that process. So we got to level 24. And we're going to... does that drinky thing again, we basically obliterate Whitney. Took almost no damage. We're almost level 25 actually as well, so we're gonna go ahead once we beat Whitney and go talk to this girl. She's a gossiper, and this gives us a squirt bottle, and we're gonna go ahead and squirt this little pseudo voodoo guy, and he's gonna come out. We're gonna go ahead and just obliterate this thing, and we're gonna use Ice Punch. It's gonna be a 3-shot, 2, and it actually is doing pretty decent damage. But we get the win, and we go ahead and get Hidden Power, and then we're going to use Hidden Power Flying. So Hidden Power Flying is the one I choose because we have to fight Fighting type, okay? So Hidden Power Flying by itself is 70 base power. Because we beat Faulkner's Gym, Fighting type or Flying type moves get a 10% boost in all Flying moves. So that means that our now going from 70 to a 77 base power move. And then when we're eventually going to get a thing called the Sharp Beak. Sharp Beak will give another 10% boost. So that puts us over, it's like an 7.7 times 10. It's 77 times 10 is 7.7. Add that to 77. And we're looking at a move just about 85 base power is what we're looking at. So that's good. And now we're fighting the Komodo Girls. So the Komodo Girls, if you've never played the game, what the Komodo Girls are, they're just They all have an EV illusion. There's 5 EV illusions in this game. In Generation 1, you have Jolteon, Flareon, Vaporeon, and in this generation, they added a Psychic and Dark type, Espeon and Umbreon. So every one of them have one of the iterations of Eevee. None of them have the base model Eevee, the normal type, but whatever. But fighting them, we get Surf, and we're able to go Surf and take on some other things. However, what we're going to do first is take on our third rival fight, and the third rival fight's going to come out. Again, we still have Bite, so Ghastly isn't really a problem. So Bite will be a two-shot, very good. And we're going to move on to Magnemite. Magnemite you got to look out for, because Magnemite can usually likes to go for Thunder Wave. But we just get a little bit of confusion, knock it out, very good. And now we're going to go out and Zubat. Hopefully we can get a one-shot on the Zubat. I hate Zubat. I hate confusion. It's such the dumbest thing ever. Okay, get the knockout there with Zubat. Then the last one is we have Ice Punch for Bayleaf. Bayleaf isn't going to do a lot of damage to us, but we do get the two-hit knockout. We beat our rival, and we're going to go ahead and progress on to Morty. So Morty's going to come out here in a second, and Morty is going to slowly go across the screen. Morty. Oh, geez, Rick. Oh, no. And Morty comes out after he winds his Rick, and he's going to come out with a Ghastly. So Bite's going to be a one-shot on the Ghastly. Very good. And Haunter's going to come out and be a one-shot on the Haunter. Very good. Gengar will not be a one-shot, which leaves us very scary. So we're going to go for Mudslap because we don't want to get hypnotized and we don't want to have Dream Eater. I think I actually blocked out one time against Morty. But we get a two-shot on the Haunter, finishing off Morty. Very easy gym. We're going to not learn Rage. Usually, Rage, like in Generation 1, Rage is like one of your first moves, so you get it pretty early, so it's great. So now we're going to talk to Jasmine, and Jasmine's going to ask to go get medicine for Ampharos. And once we go get medicine for Ampharos, we're going to go talk to this guy. He's the creepy guy with the glasses. Looks like he's blind. He gives us the medicine, and we're going to go ahead, and we're going to go for add hidden power right now. So you're seeing all this right now. Hidden power. Very good. We're going to get rid of Mudslap. Mudslap has a short shelf life, but a shelf life nonetheless. And you're going to also see me add the Sharp Beak. So adding the Sharp Beak, like I said, adds 10% boost in all flying moves. So now we're going to just obliterate Chuck and his gym. So he likes to throw boulders around, but we're going to throw him around. So here's what's going to happen. We're going to fly up, swoop in, and use Hidden Power Fly. One shot knockout, very good. Primeape is down, Poliwrath comes out, and it's going to be a two shot. Now we get put to sleep. So we gotta deal with that. So Mama Bear's gotta deal with some sleeping right now. I named it Monzilla, by the way. I've not gone over that yet. Momzilla, because it's like a Godzilla-looking creature, but it's also a mom. So then we're gonna face on Gyarados. And we're gonna beat Gyarados pretty handily. Nothing really has gonna do anything against us. So go for Bite, does nothing, which we do nothing, but Headbutt is almost a one-shot. We get the knockout. Dragon Rage did a lot of damage. We're going to come out of the water, talk to this guy with the cape. I don't know why people have to wear capes. Have you never seen Incredibles? No capes. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and face Price. Price is the Ice Gym Leader. And we don't exactly have any weakness to it. We actually have access to a lot of things that can do well. We don't add Thunder Punch because I didn't think we needed to. But we could add a Thunder Punch here to make this battle way easier. But Headbutt's a one hit against the seal and a two hit against the Dewgong. So we're down to 100 hit points and we're going into the last Pokemon, Poliwag. So what we could have done with Poliwag is we could have added Fire Punch. Fire Punch would have one shot this thing and we'd have moved on. But we get a two shot, get the knockout. And now I'm showing the Ampharos. So I hope you get the joke of me adding Ampharos as we give him his medicine. So we're going to move on after that and going to go and face Jasmine. Jasmine is the Steel Gym Leader. I don't remember if I had a Fire Punch or not for this. Because it's applicable, it's available. I don't remember if I did. I did, okay. So Fire Punch will be a one-shot on the Magnemite. We added the Charcoal, which has a 10% boost on all fire moves. So knockout there. So we have one Pokemon left. Is it a one-shot? It is not. However, a very, very good two-shot. Knocks it out. Iron Tail didn't do squat to us. We beat Jasmine. And we move on to our fourth rival fight. This is in the underground, base or whatever you want to call it, fort. And we're going to go ahead and one shot. Oh, I'm sorry. We're not going to one shot, but we are going to knock out the Golbat. What I should have done here, and I didn't do this, I should have gone through the ice path to, what's the city called? Blackthorn City and gotten an Evermelt Ice to improve that, but it's okay. Haunter comes out, we're going to go for Fire Punch again. And yeah, we don't have a move for Ghost right now. That's a great until we finish up the normal plot line. We'll get Earthquake in Victory Road, so that'll be helpful. So I'm not going to learn Dizzy Punch. We're going to skip it because we have Headbutt, same base power. It just doesn't confuses rather than Dizzy Punch confuses, whereas Headbutt will flinch. And I'd rather have Headbutt right now, at least until we get one more move, which we'll get before the Elite Four. But we beat our rival, and now we're moving on to Claire. Claire, this battle actually goes really weird for me. So we're 10 levels higher, we have the Nevermelt Ice, and Ice Punch is not a one-shot. It's surprising to me that it was not a one-shot. We do get paralyzed, unfortunately, but Ice Punch, it's a two-shot again. Don't get it. I don't understand. So I went for Return, and like maybe Return's just going to do more. And Return does do more, so we just stick with Return on this, but it's very confusing that was not a one-shot on every one of those Dragonairs with Ice Punch. But not a big deal. We, even though we're paralyzed, we do beat Claire, and we move on to Victory Road, where we face our final rival battle of this video. So he's going to come out with a Sneasel. We need a good physical attack. We'll knock it out one shot. Very good. Sneasel has low defense. Okay, Golbat comes out. Going to go for Return, just because it's more powerful right now. We're not holding anything that makes Ice Punch better. Earthquake will be a one shot in the Magneton. Very good. Haunter. Earthquake will be a one shot in the Haunter. Very good. And two Pokemon left. We just need to do a good physical damaging move to Kadabra. Very good. And the last move we're looking at here is Meganium. We're going to use Hidden Power Fly. And I think I still have the Sharp Beak. So that's why that was like a very good two shot on the Meganium. And with the rival all the way, we're going to go ahead and take on the Elite Four. But before we do, we're going to review everything about this Pokemon real quick that we have up to this moment. We are at level 50 going into the Elite Four. We have the Nevermelt Ice equipped. It gives a 10% boost in our ice moves. We also have two other moves we'll use. Our normal moves will be boosted by the Pink Bow. And our flying move, which is Hidden Power Flying, will be boosted by Sharp Beak. The moves we're going into are Ice Punch, Return, Earthquake, and Hidden Power. They all have a special use right now, and I know I did this very quickly whenever I was filming it, so hold on one second. There we go. I caught it. Yes. Okay, good. I literally like clicked through it so fast I forgot to like wait a second, but I caught it at the right time. So our stats right now, attack is 133, defense is 113, special attack is 81, special defense is 121, and speed is 126. So across the board, stats are pretty solid except for special attack, but we're only using special attack for one move and really for like to take care of one guy. So let's go and go over, let's go and take on the Elite Four. So the first member of the Elite Four is Will. And right now you can see me changing out. I'm changing out the Pink Bow for the Nevermelt Ice. It's going to give a 10% boost in our normal moves, which is the move Return. Return, like I said, very powerful. I think Return is going to be better than Ice moves because our special is so low. I think that reading the special like that is what changed my mind. So we're going to go for Return. It's a one-shot on the Zatu. Jinx comes out. One-shot on the Jinx. Very good. Now we're going to have an Exeggutor. We have two options. We do Hidden Power Flying, which, you know, almost gets a one-shot, but it's a two-shot. Slowbro comes out. Earthquake will be a three-shot. It gets a little bit seated, so that's going to be annoying. But Return does a little bit more damage, so we're going to see if we can knock him out one more time. Very good. That brings out one more Pokemon, the Zatu. Two levels higher. Doesn't matter. It's still a one-shot with Return. So we beat Will pretty handily. And then we're going to move on to Koga. Now, Koga is the poison. His main thing is poison with his Pokemon, but we need to heal up real quick. And we're probably going to switch out the item. So he has a couple bug-type Pokemon. Let's see. I think we're saving right here. Nope, we're going to stick with a Pink Bow. Perfect. So Pink Bow, our go-to move now is then it's Return. So Aridos comes out. We're going to go and go for Return. Aridos is pretty frail, so we knock it out pretty easily in one hit. Very good. Move on to Venomoth. Venomoth, Ice Punch will be a two-shot. We do get poisoned, which is not fun. Fortress comes out. Fortress takes forever to knock out in general, so fun stuff there. And now basically it's just a stall tactic. It's going to stall us out because we're poisoned already, and we're not able to hit because he's using Protect. So not fun. I think it's going to result in a reset. Yep, we do get a reset here. So, we're going to try this again. We're going to go back. And I'm going to switch in the Sharp Beak and replace Return. Return's still going to be very powerful, but I think I need a little bit of boost in the Hidden Power Flying. So, we're going to take on Koga again. Koga's going to come out with Ariados. This is not going to change. Hidden Power Flying knocks out one shot. Very good. We level up to level 52. Venomoth comes out. It's a one-shot. Very good. We don't get poison now. That's the benefit of switching into that, so we can one-shot the Venomoth. Return does about, it's about a three-shot. We still have a very good health with the last two Pokemon. Muk comes out. Return is going to be not quite a one-shot. Very close, but we do get the two-shot. And Crobat comes out. Crobat's going to be not a one-shot. So close. And goes for full restore. Not a one-shot again. And now he's used evasion, so we're going to have a little bit of time hitting him. But we do get the final hit. We knock out Crobat, we move on, and we beat Koga. We're going to go ahead and move on to Bruno. We don't talk about Bruno very much. We just got to heal up. We're going to use the same item, the Sharp Beak, to make sure our flying moves are good. He has all fighting types, so we're going to go ahead and go for that. And let's go ahead and pick on Bruno. Now, we don't talk about Bruno very much. He's actually pretty decent in Generation 2. I'll give him that. Hitmontop comes out, and we're going to go for Hidden Power. One shot, very good. Next Pokemon is Hitmonlee. One shot, extremely good. Very good. Knock him out. Hitmonchan outspeeds us, but we do get the knockout with a one shot. Now, the question is, do we beat Machamp? We do not. We have almost full health, and he one shots us with full health. That health, that was fun. That was so awesome. So, we're going to try this battle again. The concept is there. The proof of concept is there. We just got to not get one shot by Machamp. So, trying for this again. Hit and power, one shot, very good. Hitmonlee, one shot, very good. We level up, awesome. Hitmonchan, one shot. Oh, we get hit by Mach Punch, doesn't do a lot of damage. We one shot. Machamp. We don't one shot, but we actually, you know, kind of take on full blow with the cross chop. And we get in a healing loop, we knock him out. And then Onix is last, so we want to do Ice Punch. Ice Punch will end the battle very quickly. Very good. So we got three down out of the Elite Four. We got two more to go. We have Karen, who's the last member of the actual Elite Four. And then we have the champion in Lance, the Liar with the Flyers. And just got to make sure Elixir, which will restore our power points. Very good. I'm trying to decide, do I want to stick with the Sharp Beak or do I want to switch to the Pink Bow? Yep, we're switching to the Pink Bow. So now, Return will be my go-to move for everyone in on her team. So here we go. We're saving right now. We're at an hour and 28 minutes. We're doing very good on time. So here we go. I believe Karen is a first try victory, and so is Lance. So let's go ahead and watch this battle. Umbreon comes out. Umbreon's a pain in the butt. It's very bulky. So Return will be a two-shot. We do not get Sand Attack, thank God. So that's good for this battle. So the battle's already starting off on a really good foot. We're going to use Hidden Power Flying. One-shot the Vileplume. Gengar comes out. We're going to go for Earthquake. That's a one-shot. Very good. Now the next Pokemon, Murkrow. We're going to go ahead and go for either Ice Punch. Oh, Ice Punch, okay. Or Return. I think either one would have done the same result. Houndoom, Return will be a one-shot. Very good. And we beat Karen. First try victory. We don't even take any. We barely take any damage at all. And so now we're moving on to Lance. Lance is the drag. It's supposed to be quote unquote dragon type trainer, but he really only has flying type. He has a couple dragon, but Charizard and Aerodactyl are not dragon type, but they are flying type. So Gyarados, same with Dragonite. So we equipped the Nevermelt Ice because ice moves are super effective against Lance and his dragon Pokemon, his quote dragon Pokemon. So Gyarados comes out, we go for Return. Return, I don't think it's a one shot. Oh, no, it's not. We got close though. Oh, it does go for Rain Dance. So now Charizard's moves won't be very good. We knock out the Dragonite, one shot, very good. We knock out the second Dragonite. Oh, no, we don't. But we do freeze him, so it doesn't matter. We're going to win anyway. It doesn't matter now. And now Aerodactyl comes out. We're going to go for Ice Punch. It's not a one shot. Ancient Power doesn't do a lot to us. We knock it out. Very good. Charizard comes out. Like I said, any fire move is not going to do a lot because Rain Dance is on the field. And in the last Pokemon, as long as we can just get a two shot and we don't take too much damage from Outrage, very good. So now we beat Lance, and that makes us the champion. So we're going to click, 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 trying to get the fastest time possible. I was hoping to get us in under an hour and 30 minutes, but not the case, but it's okay. It's okay. I could go back and probably redo this playthrough in the future if I wanted to, and probably get a much better time. So we're going to go and lock in the time of 1 hour, 30 minutes, 54 seconds. So very good time. And that's not the end of it, though. So we have a good Elite Four time, but we're going to go move on to Kanto. Now, with the Elite Four defeated, we're going to go and move on to Kanto. We're going to go on the SS Aqua and get off the SS Aqua. There we go. Move on to Lieutenant Surge. Lieutenant Surge will be very easily beaten because we have Earthquake and we have a very good physical attack. And Earthquake super effective against all of his Pokemon. So Fat Raichu comes out. One shot on the Raichu. Very good. Electrode comes out. One shot on Electrode. Very good. Magneton comes out. Take a guess on what's going to happen here. It's going to be a knockout with Earthquake. Very good. Electro comes out one more time. Knock him out. And then his final Pokemon, his ace, is Electabuzz. And Electabuzz gets one shot. Very good. So we beat Lieutenant Surge very easily, very quickly. And now we're going to move right on to Sabrina. Sabrina is going to be kind of a similar outcome. Psychic Pokemon are very frail when it comes to physical defense. The Umbreon comes out. I actually think Umbreon has decent defense. But we're going to one-shot the Umbreon. Very good. Mr. Mime comes out. And it's going to be a one-shot. Extremely good. The only question is the Alakazam. Do we outspeed and do we one-shot? We do both. So Sabrina's a breeze. Sabrina and her whip. Actually, this generation doesn't have a whip, unfortunately. And now we're going to move on to Erica's gym. We fought everyone in here. I want to make sure we're at a good level when we get to Red. The final battle in this game, the boss battle, whatever you want to call it. So I want to make sure I got to a good level before we got here. So I'm fighting a couple extra battles in all the gyms. And now we're going to take on Erica. Erica is the grass gym leader. She's going to come out with Tangela. Tangela should be one shot by Hidden Power. That's a one shot right there. So if you have to take any damage or be attacked at all by any gym leader in Kanto. So, Hidden Power flying. Knocks out the Victory Bell. Very good. And now Blossom is coming out. Blossom is a one-shot, extremely good. And that's Erica, done and dusted. Now we're going to move on to Janine. Janine will be a little different. It won't be a string of one-shots. I mean, it might be, but I doubt it's going to be a string of one-shots. Crobat comes out. We're going to go and use Ice Punch on Crobat. That's a one-shot, very good. We're going to come out with a Weezing. We're going to go with a Return. Return's a one-shot, so maybe it will be the same result as it's been for the last couple of Pokemon. Our last level gym leaders, one shot, very good. She has two Pokemon left, Ariados will be a one shot with Return. And Venomoth comes out. Is it going to be a one shot? It is going to be a one shot. So the pattern of what's going on with all the gym leaders is continuing here in Kanto. So Misty comes out. We're going to get the water gym out of the way. Earthquake is not a one shot on old Golduck there, but we get the two shot, very good. We're at level 64, which is nice. Very nice. Earthquake's not a one-shot on Quagsire. Knock him out. Very good. Lapras comes out. And we're going to do Lapras. Earthquake, it's still going to be a two-shot, so it's not a big deal. Get the knockout. Very good with Lapras. And the last one, we're going to come out with Starmie. Starmie's pretty frail, so Return should one-shot it. Very good. So we beat Misty. We've taken a little bit of damage from her, which is unfortunate. But now we're going to move on to Brock. So in Brock's gym, he's a rock type trainer. We don't have anything. I guess Ice Punch is super effective. But we don't have any like Surf or anything. And we don't have any Stab with it. So we're just going to take Brock on. And he's going to come out with Wakanda Forever. And Graveler's going to come out. Graveler will be a one shot with Ice Punch. His next Pokemon will be a Rhyhorn or an Onix. Rhyhorn, yep. One shot as well. Oh, we added the leftovers, by the way. So we're replenishing our health every time we finish a battle. So we went for Ice Punch on accident. We did not mean to do that, but we're going to go for Return. Return will be a two shot. So we knock out Almistar. Very nice. And now we have Onix. Onix will be a one shot with Ice Punch. And we have one more, Kabutops. Kabutops should be a... I don't think it's a one-shot, but go for Earthquake. There you go. Earthquake will be a one-shot. Very good. So now we beat Brock, taking a little, very low damage as well. We're going to move on to Blaine. Blaine, Fire Gym Leader. Three Pokemon should be a pretty much clean sweep of Blaine. So he sends out Macargo. We're going to go for Earthquake. Earthquake will be a one-shot. Very good. He's going to send out Magmar next. Let's see if it's a one-shot as well. It is a one-shot. Last one is Rabidash. Rabidash is going to come out. We're going to go for Earthquake. And it's a one-shot. So we clean sweep Blaine. Very good. And now we set the face Blue. Blue has a well-rounded team, so this battle is usually a little bit tricky. But he's great preparation for Red. So he's going to come out with a flying Pokemon Pidgeot. We have Ice Punch and we have Return. I don't think either one will knock him out. Return knocks him out. My bad. Send out Alakazam. Let's go for Return again. Go for Earthquake. And I don't know why we didn't go for Return. So we've done the same thing. But Ice Punch on the Rhydon. He sets up a Sandstorm. So now we're going to take a little bit of chip damage every turn until we knock him out. But there's only three Pokemon left. So that's good. And so we also... I think we still have the... Nope, maybe not. We're not replenishing health. So we don't have the... Yeah, we don't have the leftovers on. So I think we just switched back to the return, the pink bow. So, two shot on the Exeggutor. Okay, we're still all over half health, right around half health. And we're going to Earthquake on the Arcanine. We get the one shot on Arcanine. Very good. We beat Blue. Blue is defeated. And now we're going to move on to Red. So, Red starts off with a Pikachu. We gave all of our rare candies. We're at level 75. Earthquake will one-shot the Pikachu without any issue at all. Okay. Espeon's going to come out. I'm going to go ahead and go for Return. Return will be a one-shot. Extremely good. Very good. Now, Snorlax is always a pain in the butt. Earthquake comes out. It's going to be about a third. Return does a little bit more. So, it'd be a three-shot. But now we're paralyzed, so we have to try to win the battle being paralyzed. Awesome. Now, so right now, the goal right now is, if I wasn't paralyzed, I would go for rest to replenish my health. But you don't want to do that against Snorlax, okay? So my next move is I want to go for rest. And I'm paralyzed, so he gets a one-shot on me. So that is like the whole crux of that battle. So we're going to do this battle again, and we have pretty much a proof of concept that we can get this done. Because the harder Pokemon are in the beginning, not Pikachu, but the ones that should give us the most problems. So Return is a one-shot. Very good. Espeon comes out. Return should be a one-shot with Espeon as well. Very good. So now we're moving on to Snorlax. Snorlax's Return is a little over half. Oh, we get a critical? That's awesome. So now, this is a foregone conclusion. Blizzard's going to one-shot. Oh, no. Blizzard didn't one-shot? That's insane. Oh, I went for Return. I must have gone. No, I didn't. I went for Blizzard. Charizard comes out. We're going to go ahead and go for Return. Return should be a two-shot. Flamethrower does not do that much. Still above half health. Right around half health. Get the knockout on Charizard. We're going to go for... Let's see. We're going to go for Return. A little over half. Blizzard comes out. Doesn't do enough, doesn't knock us out. We defeat Red in our second attempt. Very good battle. Very impressed with the way the Kangaskhan has handled this playthrough. And I'll be honest, like I said, I think the... I'm going to click right there. No, I'm going to do this. I'm going to click right back here where it was. And just pause it. There we go. I didn't mean to stop it. I meant to pause it. So, this is the playthrough of Kangaskhan. 2 hours and 4 minutes. Honestly, I think this could have done a lot better. I just, I fumbled a little bit when I played. It's like I'm fumbling right now when I'm talking. So, we'll be back on schedule with our playthroughs. I do have a special video that's coming out, but there's actually another video coming out soon by another YouTuber. It's kind of the same video. I'm playing through with Pokemon Blue, and he's playing through Pokemon Yellow. You'll see what it is when it comes out. And look into Scott's thoughts and see how he's doing, because he has a video. We're both posting a similar video, unbeknownst to each other. I saw a post about it, and I've already had a lot of it in the can. I just haven't edited it and put it into an actual video, so it's going to be exciting. Moving back on track, we just finished up Crobat, so I have a couple, I think Chinchou is next. So a couple good Pokemon coming up. And let me know what you think. Do you think I should bounce around and just play the ones I want to and then play the ones I don't later? Or do you think I should just stick with the Pokedex and play in order? That way, you know, it's pretty easy to pinpoint what my next Pokemon is. And you guys can keep track of it as well, pretty easy. So let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Happy Mother's Day to everyone. If you're a mother, happy Mother's Day. If you're not a mother, go tell your mother happy Mother's Day. All right? Have a good one, and I'll see you guys next time.